When am I going to get my money?
Begging for money is not something Catherine Hall ever thought she would have to do.
I had to run to the bank 2 Fridays ago and beg them to give me a loan just so that I could pay my contractor. And once he's finished doing this segment of the work, we have to stop because we don't have any more money.
Nearly 4 months since Superstorm Sandy destroyed her home in Island Park, New York, Hall has been calling her mortgage banker almost every day. She's begging them to release insurance money so she and her family can rebuild and go home.
We have a 4-year-old little boy who basically we spent his college fund. You know, the money that we've put by since his birth towards being able to send him to college later in life is what we've spent. It's gone.
Hall, who is originally from Britain, and her husband Bob and 4-year-old son Nathan have been living in a hotel since November. The Halls are among more than 6,000 families still waiting for insurance money. New York's governor blamed unnecessary red tape and accused banks of failing to release more than $200 million worth of insurance. The problem is some lenders require proof the repair has been made before they will reimburse for the cost of that repair.
There's a lot of older people here that, you know, that just don't have any money. And they're being told that, you know, do 30% of the work and then they'll get 30% of the money. Do 50% of the work, you'll get 50% of the money.
The reason that they do that, I think, is that they're scared that you're going to get the check and leave them with a property that's not sellable. You know, but we've invested a lot of money in this house, you know, and it's our home.
Banks contacted by CNN, including Wells Fargo, J.P. Morgan, Citibank, and Bank of America, tell CNN they've distributed more than 75% of all insurance money. The Hall's mortgage lender, who they asked we not name, did not respond.
You know, we came here to live the American dream, and now we're living the American nightmare because they're holding our money and we can't get it. And it's not fair, you know, it's not fair on anyone. And everybody is in the same position, everybody. I don't, like I said to you, I don't know a single person who's had a dime.
And the waiting and uncertainty is taking a toll as devastating as the storm itself.